with Splash Moon, I can never remember this, I want to say 431?
Yep.
Yeah, got it. Okay, for today we're going to be looking at this leak thing. Not sure.
It's a supposed leak. Apparently what happened is that someone who's working on the games drew the entire Gen 7 Pokédex for a minute with pen.
Which seems a bit suspicious, I think.
It does seem so suspicious.
I understand maybe they sketched down a couple of them, but every single one?
Yeah.
And they all have blurry names and numbers next to them.
Even the types.
Grass type, but I'm talking about more of the water type, but I see what you mean. It's like, maybe I'd say flower type thing, plant, Venus flytrap maybe?
Because if you look under it, it has a second type.
Good point. No idea what that's
what
like.
Is that? Does it say poison?
Even though it would say poison, it'd be in Japanese anyway, wouldn't it?
No, actually, under one of the other ones, it says ground in English.
Oh, I see one that says fairy in English.
Yeah. So, I think maybe the types they put in English.
Maybe. Do they translate across the game? I don't know. They don't, do they? Types?
Well, I know that. I know that in Japanese, dark type is called the evil type.
Okay. So I think they translate the same.
Yeah.
One across, which looks like a weird evolution mixed with Charmander mixed with Mew's legs. You see what I mean?
Yep.
It's got Charmander tail.
Perfect summary of that thing right there.
I don't like that.
Huh.
At all.
I just don't even know what it is.
I think we should pass that. That's a confusing mess.
It has no arms.
That's slightly creepy.
Yeah.
And then its next evolution, it gets arms, and looks a bit like a wannabe Mega Lucario.
Yeah.
You see the things coming out of the back of its head?
Yeah. The things coming out of its head.
And surely the stars would have two evolutions.
Oh man, I don't know at this point, like...
Because we've had Stars of Mega Evolution since, Mega Ruby Alpha Sapphire, so... Surely they...
Not necessarily. Not necessarily.
I don't know, there's a high chance of that happening.
In Pokemon X and Y, they gave Blaziken Mega Evolution. And they gave all the Kanto starters Mega Evolutions too. But not the actual starters, the Gen 6 starters from that game.
Yeah, that is no Mega Chestnut or no Mega Greninja or something like that. Mega Greninja would look pretty cool, though.
But apparently their reasoning for that was that they wanted to focus Mega Evolutions on old Pokemon only, but then after Mega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, they made Mega Dynasty.
Yeah, that explains the Mega... Mega Diancie's cool, but...
Yeah, really cool.
Should we move on to the next one?
Yeah, this one...
Now, this one's just Mega Lucario's trousers and Mega Blaziken's cape.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
It's just so heavily shaded in. I cannot even make out a face. It's definitely a fighting type, for sure. I mean...
Yeah, it says fire and then something underneath
the it has to be fire something. Why did they shade in the type things?
Whoever did this is either trying to trick us or it's just being quite irritating.
Mate, I mean they did this in pen. So why are they shading stuff in? Give us the outline. That's all we need.
Should we move on to the next one, which is probably my favourite, and if these do turn out to be the stars, it's definitely the one I'll pick. Looks like Baby Sharpedo.
I'm unsure of which one I pick, but this one looks kind
definitely
of...
Definitely not the fighter.
I'll say this. This one looks like the most confident one out of all of these.
Yeah,
yeah,
I agree.
The other two look... Yes, the fire type one's looking confused at this situation, and the grass type is just happy to be here.
Always showing off his muscles, you know, he's got those big guns.
So this thing, I'm not even sure about this. Its arms. Do you think it actually even has arms? Or do you think those are some sort of claw-like things? Or is claw
the... talking about the water type starter, right?
Yes.
Yeah, got that. I just say they're fin-like arms, and it seems to, in this next evolution,
oh, yeah.
Kind of see fingers kind of coming out. out the end. And it evolves like a proper fin-like tail.
Yeah, fin-like tail. It has like... Actually, I think that might be some sort of buoyancy-like thing around its neck.
Oh, my armbands!
Yeah! On the, so maybe this one's good at swimming.
Like, the Weavile one with the armband. What was that one called?
What?
The Weavile Pokemon that has, like, the blue armbands.
Oh, God, Ash has one.
Evil,
do you know what I'm talking about?
Evil Pokemon with blue armbands?
No, it's just the Weavile Pokemon that has a blue armband sort of like inflation thing around itself. Water type.
The water type?
I completely forgot what that's called.
Water types. Therapy. Water types.
I'll try and find it. We're wasting a lot of time on this.
Just trying to compare it.
Weavile. Is it? Wait. No, that's not it. It's something Weavile.
That's not a
word. No, not Weavile. It's something close to that. I can't remember what it is.
Because
Weavile's a bad.
Close to that. Arm.
It's gonna irritate me the rest of the
day. Wait. Is it Swampert?
I found it! It's not Weavile. It's B-U-I-Z-E-L. Boozle.
Oh, Weasel. Oh.
Weasel! Does it sound like Weasel? I'm confused. That one, because it has like an inflation thing around its neck, and then the whole thing.
Oh, how could I forget Weasel? Weasel!
It's similar armband style thing.
Yeah. Oh yeah, Weasel comes from the word buoyant and weasel. So.
Good point.
And then floating weasel for floatzel.
So, this evolution line looks basically like he's just getting bigger. There's not a massive change. He doesn't just seem to get bigger.
I'll say that he does definitely get tougher.
He looks more brooding, definitely.
Oh, definitely.
Oh, and then the next one across from the water type evolution chain looks really weird.
Yes. I think the major thing to consider here is that this person is drawing all of them from memory, and is probably going to get some details wrong, and is going to have trouble actually drawing some of these.
Yeah, that definitely would be one. There was one here.
I'm trying to imagine what. Does it look like it has some sort of bow around its neck?
Some sort of collar type thing, maybe.
That's what I was.
Because something I discovered is the stones, the little crystals that we saw in the Japanese logos.
Yes.
Those relate to in the Pokemon manga. Those are the crystals that allow human Pokemon combinations.
Oh gosh.
Just in the manga, there's somebody who gets combined with a Zekrom using that stone. Have you seen Ash Greninja?
Oh man, Ash Greninja. Apparently that's confirmed to be a show exclusive thing.
Yeah, but it's got the same principle though. You can easily travel that principle into the game.
Pokemon Fusion? Human and Pokemon Fusion? That just sounds like
is the manga coinciding with the games? Are they in the same universe? I think they are, aren't they?
No. The manga, the anime, and the games, they're all separate.
Okay, but a lot of things have travelled over from the manga and the
anime. Yeah, but they're the same franchise, that's the thing.
Yeah.
But the one with the fusion in it, I think that was a spin-off manga, like a crossover series.
But it could easily play a part in it, because it can't be a coincidence the crystals look so much when we've seen an Ash Greninja. It, that is
an Ash Greninja. Oh man. Well, like, you can unlock an Ash Greninja Picross level in Pokemon Picross. So yeah.
I was not aware of that. I was just thinking, this is completely off the subject, but I think I at least might do this in a two-part video. Yeah. There's quite a lot to get over here.
Yeah.
Okay. Just completely off task, but okay, should we continue? Wait, I have no idea how we start talking about that.
Well, it looks like some sort of mysterious, like, I'm thinking it's a water type of some sort.
Either that or fairy, definitely that water or fairy, because I can see that as some sort of...
Perhaps even a psychic type.
Something that just floats, they're like, yeah. Because it reminds me of regular Mew a little bit, like, it just floats, seemingly floats in midair.
Yeah, psychic type.
Should we go on to the next one?
Yeah, next one. Do you think this one is an evolution of the previous one? Because, I mean, you know...
It could be. It's got the same tail, ears. It's kind of looking like a Pikachu. There's too many Pikachu-like Pokemon, though. There's the DNA and stuff.
So many.
I don't like that.
So yeah, it has its left paw over its mouth. It has cheeks like Pikachu, eyes like Pikachu, ears like Pikachu.
Seems to be a Pikachu without the Thunderbolt tail, really.
Yeah. Instead it has a Mewtwo clone tail.
Pretty much.
And then after that,
the next one seems to be like a
Kangaskhan clone.
A Nido King, Nido Queen style thing.
If you look at the
first one on the bottom, next row down, that seems to be like a male equivalent, because this one has the female symbol.
Yeah, but it seems similar to Kangaskhan in that it has a baby in its pouch. It has a baby in its pouch.
Kangaskhan's a baby in its pouch, though.
Well, I mean, what's to stop them from reusing ideas, you know?
Good point. I mean, it's extremely similar. It's Kangaskhan. Kangaroo and something else. I don't know. Not sure if they'd do a kangaroo.
A male equivalent to that might be
good. There is a male equivalent. It's first thing on the bottom row.
Yeah, I know, that's what I think. That's what I see.
Yeah, I think that's just going to be the same start as that, if it's right.
It has two types, the first one. So does the second.
Yeah, and the second one's all blanked out on both.
Blanked out.
I assume that would be brown or normal, I'd say.
Yeah, ground something, I guess.
The next one along in the bottom row is...
Something flying, for sure.
Yeah, it looks like a...
It's type of something flying.
It's like a small vulture.
Huh. I thought with the way it's posing, it's like Swanna. You know, with the...
But if you look at the second one, which we can pretty obviously see, you seem to be an evolution of it.
Yeah,
it's
definitely.
Dark.
It's
definitely a dark type. It's going to be. If you end up these pictures, you're going to go on.
But remember, dark type, evil type, but it has to exhibit some sort of dark-like traits. Or maybe look a bit mischievous.
I'd say it looks quite creepy, if anything. Both of them.
Definitely, yeah.
Either the way it's drawn, with it being so dark, or it's...
That might be intentional. It could be a dark type, or it could be a ghost type either. The next one...
Yeah.
Just reminds me of
that's
Fennekin.
Weird.
The next one just reminds
me. Fennekin
with four ears, Pikachu, cheeks, and Emolga's tail.
Pretty much. A lot of these do seem to be just combinations of other Pokemon, which personally would leave well, to say are not real, but I think they're worth analysing anyway.
Yeah, but like, hey, you know, this is a game with 700 training characters now, like, we're going to see some similarities in that one.
Yeah, most of these are not similar at all to any other Pokemon that I've seen.
So, the one after that is obviously an evolution to this. It looks quite definitely bigger. And
yes, I'd say it looks more powerful. Got the Pikachu type tail. These are definitely electric types, definitely.
Definitely electric type.
That one's also quite a shady drawing, so it's not too easy to say what's going on in that one.
It's looking up towards the top right and has things coming out of its head. Actually, kind of like Soul Spark does.
Yeah, so what's the pre-evolution of Soul Spark? That little deer.
Deer Link.
Yeah, that's what the other one looks like. You remind me of that. I just couldn't remember the name.
Unlike Soul Spark, Deer Link just has a flower instead of like actual branches / trees coming out of his head.
I'd say they're apples actually, but they're kind of trees. I think like this one has the small ears, and then the evolution has the massive like thunderbolt-esque ears.
Yeah.
Should we move along to the next one with the weird black patch over its eyes?
Yes, this extremely it's extremely happy. That's for sure.
It seems to have really, really short, stubby arms.
Yeah, very short arms, and a big, poofy tail.
Actually, I'd say that's either a beaver type, like-esque tail, or just a big, round tail. I don't know what to say. Because it could be the way it's shaded in, that it looks like a ball, or it could be, I don't know.
It looks like it's wearing some sort of hat.
Yeah, so there's a pretty fabulous hat.
Yeah.
The three little. They could be mushrooms. They remind me of mushrooms, those little things on the hat. I'd say that looks like a grass type.
A grass type, because, I don't know, maybe that could be some sort of plant life on its head.
I'm thinking it's a mushroom hat.
A mushroom hat? Then it could be. Oh man, its type is blanked out. I cannot see it. It's so blurry.
Struggles. But is there? I don't think anybody can read that. There is literally just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 dots.
Just 5 dots.
Great way of finding out the typing.
Oh yeah. Next one.
I think that looks quite cool. Dual type. One of them's fairy.
It has no face.
It just has no face. Don't judge it. It just has no face.
Actually, what if? You see those little lines on its, on its like.
Reminds me of Jirachi.
What if those are its eyes?
That'd be really creepy, actually.
Good. Well, it's part fairy, actually.
But I'd say it looks like Jirachi because it has like the same sort of spread out. Sort of
I can see that. Looks like Jirachi.
If it had some kind of, it's obviously not, probably 90.
When I first saw this thing. It reminded me of Brayxen. The evolution of Finnegan.
I actually mean like the sort of dress thing that's going on.
Yeah, that's why I said it looks like Brayxen.
Yeah. Go for the next one across?
Yep.
No idea what that is.
I don't even know.
No idea. It looks like some spiky Mickey Mouse style trousers. A halo. I don't know.
Doesn't look like a halo, it looks like it's just jutting out of its head.
Maybe a bold or a...
Who knows?
It could be the golf hole Pokemon for all I know.
The shading on these, it's just...
irritating.
Yes. And the fact that we can't... And the fact that there's words written here, and they're in Japanese, and it's too blurry to read them anyway.
Yeah, it doesn't make it an easy job.
It's not easy at all.
The next one, and I assume it's next to that.
Yep.
The evolution version looks like Hawlucha.
Huh.
Do you know what I mean?
Kaluga. Are you talking about the thing spreading its wings?
Yeah.
Ah, okay. That reminds me of Pidgeot. And Pidgeot is...
A little bit, but it has like...
It's a nice, distinctive little type of head.
If you look, it has... Wait, let me just look up a picture. I recommend you do this too, so you can try and compare them. He has, Palucha between his legs, has two little feathers that go down. You see that?
Palucha fighting types, searching, and... Palucha. Load. Okay, let's see.
So he has like two feathers that go between his legs.
So...
And then if you look back to the other picture, okay. That also has two little feathers that go between his legs.
So...
Which looks all pretty similar to me.
Yeah.
So this one, except Palucha has more like a, I want to say humanish face.
A humanish face, and yeah. Although it looks like it's wearing a mask, which goes against the whole. No, I mean which goes with the whole Lucha wrestler theme it has.
Yeah.
This thing though.
And then the next one.
It looks like a puffy bird. Which is breaking things, pretty much.
And number 743, the one next to the Halucha.
Oh, yes, see the numbers. Absolutely complicated.
That looks like it's an evolution of the other one. It has claws for feet, it has big horns, I don't know, I don't like
it. It has huge antler-like horns, big wings, a puffy looking thing around its neck. Chicken-like legs and claws on its feet, and then it has a puffy thing on its tail. With it.
If I were designing these Pokemon, I'd just put that in a drawer somewhere where nobody could find it, along with the other weird Mewtwo fire starter thing. I don't know. Is there much to talk about on that one? It's a bit of a jumbled mess, to be honest.
And then. On to the next one. This next one's pretty interesting.
He looks like he's fishing.
But he has his back towards him.
Yeah. What's the name of...
You can clearly tell he's turning around.
Yeah. It looks like he's talking to the one next to him that also has a stick. I'll be honest. It does. It looks like that.
But that's not possible. These are individual pictures.
I know, but it's, I don't know, it's just a way of
playing. Okay, so...
He also looks like, he reminds me of Panchow, with the twig thing he's holding.
Yeah.
And the bear look, and then the,
Breaks in, holds the twig, but its twig is, like, way smaller.
Yeah.
This thing, it looks like the twig is actually its tail. If you think about it.
Itch. I see where you're coming from, I'm not sure about that one.
It does, I don't know, I'd say a bear, some sort of tiny bear.
Yeah, and then the next one to it, I assume, is just an evolution, because it's also got the stick like...
Yeah, it
reminds me of Tyrantrum. It has like the eyes and the thing around its neck, Tyrantrum.
Yeah.
Another
Pokemon with puffy stuff around its neck.
Seems to be It
seems to be holding a stick, so maybe the last one is actually holding a stick.
Yeah, that's kind of where I got that from.
Yeah.
I don't see any Sun or Moon related things. Yeah, just scrolling down this picture here, I don't see anything that's really related to a Sun or a Moon. So.
I think they saved the legendary for that. But working exclusives, like, they usually don't have that much to do with the actual thing.
Goodbye.
They usually are just version of exclusive for the sake of being working exclusive.
Yeah. Should we go on to the next one?
Yes, this thing. I don't even know.
That looks like a
and caterpillar version.
It looks like something with a crocodile head and then a crocodile head on snake.
Pretty much.
With
no idea what's going on in that one.
Out of it, or what? Okay, anyway. Close.
The next one looks like, I don't think this one has an evolution. It looks like it should. It's Firefox, I think.
A Firefox?
Not as in the web browser. As, as in a fiery fox. It seems to have a flame on its tail. Maybe.
It does. Or it could be a leaf.
Type, like,
it could be a leaf.
Yeah, it could be. Or it could be a bushy tail, like a lion style tail.
Yeah, or just a regular bushy tail.
Pretty much. And the earliest one typing, I'd probably say normal.
Normal, definitely. And given how long the word looks, it probably is normal. If you think about it.
Yeah.
The next one says ground.
What next? Looks like
this is ground.
Zygarde pool. Love it.
It looks like Drakeen, but even younger.
Yeah, and then it has an evolution next to it, which looks like
Dragonair.
Head Dratini. Dragonair. So they look similar.
Yeah, and once again, it's a ground type.
So that's why sort of style.
If the thing after that is its evolution, then oh man, what a change has happened.
Don't think so.
I mean,
I'm just surprised about that.
It looks like some
sort of grown wings.
First of all, it looks like a human. It looks like a human-like fairy. Like seriously, very human-like fairy.
And this does actually. This is no. I wouldn't say this is the same because it would have got rid of its ground typing because it said something and flying, and that's not enough space to say ground.
You're right.
I'd say that's an individual Pokemon, and then next to that one is the cool winged fairy one.
Yeah.
That looks like.
I'd say the last one is fairy flying. Anyway, next one. Dark type. Instantly.
How?
I don't know, it just looks to me like it has some sort of mischievous look going on.
I see what you mean. I'll probably go with bug type myself.
Because it has...
Like, and it's quite short words, then.
Yeah, instant like.
One next one. I assume the evolution is out of the way poor antler.
It looks like it's wearing an awesome looking mask kind of face.
But anyway, it looks like it's dressed as a ninja.
Oh, that is so brilliant. So brilliant with the legs. Yes.
It reminds me of Genesect for some reason.
Genesect.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can see that.
Is Genesect a bug type or not?
I think it's bug steel.
Yeah.
But you could change its type.
Yeah, you can, depending on the URL drives. I would know. I've got a shiny one.
You have a shiny one. You said that.
I've got shiny everything. I've got quite a few shinies.
Yeah. Anyway, next one. This one looks like
a bee, a wasp, something like that. Flying bug type.
A fairy looking butterfly thing.
That could be a firefly.
Huh.
Thing on the end of its head. So it could be
the glowing thing from Firefly.
Is it a possibility?
Yeah. But then it's evolution.
The looks of it seems to lose one wing and then grow like a massive stinger style thing.
And then
loses
its like face and favorite one eye. Oh yeah, big change right there.
Maybe not change for the better. Should we move to the next one?
Next one looks like it's a bit.
I'd say it's a bear of some sort with like pointy ears and stars on the end and then little white gloves.
Its head kind of reminds me of Bannett. One looks like some sort of pre-evolution for my Ludic.
I think it's pre-evolution of survival. Good at the tail, the right shape, good at the tongue,
yeah.
The right shape. Survival has the fangs, it's perfect. Literally everything matches.
A pre-evolution for... Oh wait a minute. If that's a pre-evolution for Survivor, then look at the one next, before it, and that could be pre-evolution for Zangoose.
Yeah, I see that.
That they both.
Good point.
Zangoose with that same angry expression, the claws, the body shape, the two pre-evolutions for the both of them.
Could well be. The only thing is that I don't think he doesn't quite have the patterns that Zangoose does.
Yeah, but it's a pre-evolution.
Scenario.
But it's a pre-evolution, so it would be less complicated looking. I mean...
Yeah, okay. I said the baby survivor though, does look a bit... It doesn't look menacing at all, it looks quite happy, it looks cute and small. And
yeah, it looks pretty... It looks pretty harmless. Unlike Zangoose, which is still pretty angry.
The next one looks like a, I want to say, Tyrant. Is that the pre-evolved version of Tyrantrum?
Yep. Tyrant.
Yeah, it looks like a pre-evolved version of Tyrant.
Pre-evolved?
I don't think it would be, though. But it looks like a younger Tyrant to me. It looks similar.
Some sort of dinosaur-looking thing.
Tyrant's
but
quite cute.
Yeah. Some sort of dinosaur
that would definitely be one you could have them. Actually, thinking about that, if you look at the one next to it, that also looks like a crusty old shark type thing. That could be something that you
But keep in mind this too, that all fossil Pokemon are part rock type.
Good point, that only has one type.
I don't know, it could be.
It could be
pure rock type. I mean,
that would make sense to the dinosaur.
Yeah, it works for a dinosaur. Like you said, a crusty old shark. I keep thinking that the shading has something to do with it, but it doesn't, apparently. Because if this is rock, and then the next thing would have to also be rock, and they're both fossils, but that type is shaded and the other one isn't. Do you think they just wrote the wrong type and they crossed it out?
Yeah, the look of it, this is definitely not finalized, so...
Nothing will...
Let's not pin anything down.
This game's not coming out till the holidays. I mean, plenty of time. Plenty of time for them to finalize.
And then next one after that seems to be an evolution of the shark one, which looks really undetailed and...
To be honest, it looks like it has two flippers in the front, a tail sticking out the back, a huge giant shell, and it looks
it's like shell on the spine.
And it looks like it's looking upwards and roaring.
Yeah, I see that, yeah. And then the next two, I don't know.
Some water type. That's all that can be.
And then the next one, which is number 761, looks like a new...
An evolved version of the one before it.
Yeah, that doesn't look necessarily rubbed out or anything, so it's difficult to say about that one. For the other one, I'd say that looks like a Mew. It looks really weird.
That's the one I'm talking about.
Okay.
The one... the long tail and the stripes along its body.
Yeah, it's very strange.
The other thing, let's go with some sort of evil ghost seed. That's the best I can think of for this thing.
Something like that. I'd say that's a psychic dog, something like that.
And then it looks as if it evolves into some sort of some sad crying ghost thing.
Yeah.
Like Ghastly. Except Ghastly isn't crying. He looks to be very mysterious.
Yeah, have you seen Spirited Away? What's that? It's a movie, it's amazing. Have you seen that? Actually, we haven't.
No.
I recommend you watch it as soon as possible on the trip. But it looks like there's a character in it. If you Google No Face, there's a character in it.
Let's see.
And the masks look quite similar.
Okay, let's see. Spear.
Have you heard of My Neighbor Totoro?
No. Spirited Away.
Wow. Okay. Well, I recommend you check out Studio Ghibli as a whole. They're great. The movie studio. You see?
Ah, okay.
With the kind of the marks underneath the eyes and stuff
the
like
markings
that.
On the... Yeah, okay, now I see what you mean. With the markings.
They're definitely similar.
Okay. So...
And the next one looks like a bear mode with main entering.
Yep, that sums it up. With the spikes along its body. Looks all electric-like.
Definitely, I'd say electric type.
I mean, if there's one thing to say about this thing and its evolution, they're ready to go. They're ready to fight. They got their electricity stored up and they're ready to fight.
Seems so. And then the next one just looks like Shane's.
What?
Pretty much.
It reminds me of Del Caddy, except it decided to wear its fur as a headgear.
I see that. It's kind of wrapped its hair around its head, and then apart from that,
yes,
that's
it. It's trying to be even more like Shinx's tail. Yes, Shinx's tail. It's trying to be even more fancy than it is.
I'm trying to be fabulous.
Next one. Actually, okay, next one looks like an evolution of that.
I think I would say it is. And after this one, I think I'll end my video and I'll do mine in two parts. Because this is getting quite late, I think.
I think I'll do mine in two parts.
So yeah, I'd say that looks like... It does... Oh, what's the name of that? Of like leopard Pokemon.
Leopard Pokemon?
Yeah.
Can you describe it more?
I'll look it up. It's like purple and yellow.
Purple and yellow.
Yeah. Ah, leopard.
Oh, leopard.
Leopard. Leopard. How do you pronounce it?
Leopard.
Reminds me of that, like the stance at least. Reminds me of that.
Oh yeah, the pose. Yep, like leopard. It looks like it has.
Like you're standing quite proud.
It looks like it's. Hair-like thing has grown into like very long hair, and the tail has grown into like a flower thing. I think that's what it is.
Yeah, it seems to just have gone into a darker version of the Shinx-like tail from the other one.
Yeah.
I think I'm gonna end my video here. Yeah.
Okay.
I'll do mine in two parts. So I hope people watching my video. I hope you enjoyed watching this. Second part should be up soon. And goodbye, people watching my video. Have a great day. Okay, that's good watching my video, Donna. We can continue with yours.
Okay. So.
Okay.
Does that mean you're going to do your intro again?
I don't know.
I think you should.
Do you want to finish your video up? That'll be rather easy, I don't know.
Okay, okay, I guess I'll finish up mine too, and then we can just restart it again right after.
Okay, I'm going to back in 15 minutes.
Okay, so thanks for watching this. discussion with Splashy Totodile over the images in this leak. So be sure to leave a like, they also help the channel a lot, and be sure to subscribe for some more Pokemon content, and be sure to check out Splashy Totodile's channel too. Alright.
Yeah.
Alright, thanks for watching.
Okay.